Now, since Kentaro Miura died, the author of Berserk, I didn't think I'd ever have to do one of these type of videos for quite a long time, and I think this is probably going to be the second to last one where it's probably going to hit me on a personal level really hard. I hope I never have to do this type of video on Kubo in any time soon, because that will really fuck me up. But if you guys haven't heard the news, the creator of Dragon Ball, Dr. Slump, the character designer for Dragon Quest, if I forgot the name, I forget, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Akira Toriyama has died. And, he was 60, 68? Yeah, 68 years old. And it is a reality that a lot of us don't really expect to happen, right? Like, it's Akira Toriyama. He wasn't exactly old, as far as we knew, he was healthy, and it seems that he died due to some sort of head trauma, bleeding of the inside of the head between like the part in between the brain and the skull. I don't know the specific scientific name. I'll have like a Google image depending if I can be bothered to edit it. But to make a video, I feel is like the least I can do. I think everybody worldwide, I don't have to emphasize it enough how big Dragon Ball has been to a massive generational art level, but also a cultural, economic level too. Dragon Ball is probably, arguably, maybe up there with maybe Superman, Batman, and even Spider-Man. To be fair, I'd argue even bigger. I really would argue even bigger that Goku in the Dragon Ball series, let alone has, even if you've never watched the series, you've come across its influence in one way or another multiple times. Not just once, not twice, but multiple times. And that's the thing, is like I can sit here and I wish I could like put a USB in my head, plug it into a PC, and just show you this childhood journey of Dragon Ball. There was a time when I was a kid and I believed that like I was the biggest Dragon Ball fan ever. I believed that I knew everything about these characters. I knew everything about this story, left, right, back to center, inside and outside. I knew everything. I remember my parents buying me like they would go to Toys R Us and they'd buy like a collection of like Dragon Ball like little mini figurines. And I remember one day I was told that they didn't do the mini figurines anymore at Toys R Us, and I was devastated. But I used to play with them in the bath and just like start fighting. It's stupid, right? But that's what I grew up with, and it was on Toonami or Cartoon Network, blah blah. I think everyone has pretty much the same gist of their childhood, regardless. And as I said, you just grow up with it. And if it wasn't for Toriyama, if it wasn't for his influence, I mean, forget about my childhood. People like Kubo, people like Oda, people like Kishimoto, One Piece, Naruto, Bleach, all these series that exist today, Shonen Jump as a company, Viz Media, Funimation, Ocean Dub, all these companies that you grow up with that exist today, that provide anime content, promote this medium. Even Cartoon Network and Nickelodeon, Disney XD, all these companies, at some way, shape, or form, have had a massive, some of them were founded on Dragon Ball, right? Funimation, for sure. Funimation, I think, was the reason that the creator or the CEO of Funimation, I think his company started off by wanting to bring Dragon Ball to the West. And then he asked, Toei Animations or whoever the fuck, right? I'm giving like it's really quick rundown. Funimation was built from that series. And, it's just one of those situations, even with the creator of Yu-Gi-Oh! I mean, that hit, that did. Like, I had Yu-Gi-Oh! Cards, but like, Dragon Ball, like, on another level. Nobody. Even for me, I don't know what to say. Like, even making this video seems like a bit of like a meme, like I'm April Fool's in, or the title's gonna be clickbait, right? Because it just doesn't seem real. And the least I can do is make a video because it is a massive part of my life. Without Akira Toriyama, without Dragon Ball, there'd be no, to me, there'd probably be no anime. And there definitely wouldn't be Bleach, right? Without Dragon Ball, there'd be no Bleach, there'd be no One Piece, there'd be no Naruto, there'd be no Shonen Jump as it is today. And if it's not for, you know, Kubo making Bleach, then I wouldn't be on YouTube. Or maybe I'd be doing something else. Or I wouldn't be in Japan right now. Like, there's so... Just because this man existed and he put that pen to paper, he's created a tree branch of so many different life choices for billions of people. And that's not an over-exaggeration. Billions of people in Mexico, it is... In the Hispanic culture in general, it is fucking massive. There was a time Dragon Ball Super Goku versus Jiren, an actual political economic feud between Mexico and Japan, because Mexico as a country, the governor had to ask Japan to live stream the Goku versus Jiren fight like it was an actual fucking pay-per-view publicly in a fucking stadium. Do you know how insane that is? It broke servers upon, you know, different websites as a whole. Dragon Ball is, you know, it's its own beast. It really is the knockoff toys that you get when you go abroad. You know, the games in and of itself. It has carried generation upon generation influence. And if you're telling me as a person you've never tried a Kamehameha wave or tried to go Super Saiyan, you're fucking lying to me, right? And everything that I say is something that isn't unique to me, because everybody's had this experience. And I guess in my own way, the reason why I'm making this video is to kind of come to terms with it, to understand what this silent voice in my head is saying, because I've been sitting here for about an hour or so. I've watched the news on NHK, I've watched Japan's reaction, I've been seeing, you know, Nausicaa, the voice actor for Goku, she can't even say anything. The voice actor for Goku, she just said, I don't want to comment, I don't want to talk. I can't imagine the absolute pain that woman is going through. You know, to be the voice actor of Goku since the 1980s, you know, coming into it now, like, the creator of Dragon Ball, it's unprecedented. You know, for his family, for... You know, you have people like CC2, who did the Dragon Ball Kakarot game. They're taking, you know, a day off work. To see the obituaries of all the mangaka, all the character designers, everyone that worked closely with him, to see all the tweets. This guy was a different beast. You know, you are going to get, you know, one in every generation of this type of human. You know, He was just something. And the more that I think about... I mean, I can't possibly think about all the memories. You know, it's one of those where it's got to sit with me. And then after it sat with me, it's going to hit. Because even now, it's silent in my head. You know, it hasn't quite clicked. But I know, I read tweets and I feel it. But it's not there yet, because it doesn't seem like... It doesn't seem real. It's like, what? You know? Many people haven't even woken up. People are going to wake up to maybe this video. People are going to wake up to that tweet from Shueisha and see... And the crazy thing is, this was probably 6 days ago. Toriyama probably died 6 days ago, or his funeral was 6 days ago. He's been dead for arguably maybe a week, and none of us even knew. And that's, you know, it's incredible, you know. And then the more you think about it, and the more of this rabbit hole you go down, I think the reality sits in where you're like, fuck, now I'm getting old, right? Those childhood memories, those heroes that, like, influenced your life behind the scenes, now that they're gone, like, damn, you're getting older. Right? And then you think about the people who influence you now in your generation, and you think, fuck, they're getting older too. And, you know, I think, I don't want to think about who's next, but I think we can all, when we talk about who's next, in terms of, like, the anime and manga world, of who's probably going to go. I think we're all looking at a certain individual, and I think that that's going to be tragic too. If you're interested, I'm thinking about Yoshihiro Togashi. And I think that that's going to be something else. And then maybe, you know, and then we're going to start getting into our generation. And it's just going to hit harder and harder and harder each time. And I think this, you know, I think this is going to cause a massive worldwide uproar. I'm already seeing it with the massivest influencers, the biggest news articles. And I think this is going to be a testament to show exactly how big Toriyama's influence was. And where you go from here, I don't know. What we do, I don't know. But all I can say is the people that influence our lives, the people that put in hard work for years upon years, just show them your love and appreciation. Even if, you know, even if you got older and you got over it, I don't know. I mean, with people with Dragon Ball, people don't like Dragon Ball Super. I love Dragon Ball Super. I think it's fucking cool. You know, this is the whole country of Japan funded for Dragon Ball Battle of Gods. I think it's I quite like Super because it gives me that childhood brain of just motherfuckers punching each other. It's great. And it has a little bit of sprinkle of story in there as well. It's not as gruesome as it was in the original, but you know, it's still nice. But that's me, and I appreciate it, and I love it. And as much as people may or may not like it, it's Toriyama, baby. We love Dragon Ball. We love him. We love, you know, the Dr. Slump. We love, you know, Dragon Quest, Chrono Trigger. Remembered it. Sandland didn't really peep, but still, you know. He is a man of many talents, and I respect everything that he's done over the years. And I guess this video is to say, thank you, Toriyama. And though I don't know what to say, thank you for the opportunities you've given me, the opportunities you've given my influencers or influencees. I don't know what the correct word. And you've made people genuinely good people over the years. And I think out of all my childhood, when it comes to media watching especially, there was never a show like yours. And even though it was censored and even though the dub was absolutely tragic, you know, that's a Western diff, you know. We didn't care as kids, you know. We enjoyed it nonetheless, you know. What's it called when you have the Mandela effect? I still remember that first episode of watching Goku versus Raditz, and I remember saying to my mom, I was like, am I allowed to watch this? There's blood. And I think she just said, yeah, whatever, it's cool. Like, I can't remember specific, but it was like a nonchalant, like, yeah, whatever, it's cool. Like, I actually asked my mom for permission to watch Goku versus Raditz. And I think it must have been a Mandela effect, because where I remember blood, I don't think there was. I can't remember. But I don't think there was, so it's like, it's imagination. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed listening. Sometimes people just want to listen in the background to get their thoughts and feelings about how they feel about, you know, Akira Toriyama. And I think he was such a Chad as well, from everything from martial arts, which was definitely something that influenced me, the whole martial arts thing as well. Obviously there was other influences in regards to my martial arts background, but that was definitely there as well. You know, I wonder what Jackie Chan feels about this, because I know that him and Jackie Chan were really close as well. And just, I think what the appeal for Dragon Ball was to me, you know, was that Journey to the West vibe, that, you know, happy-go-lucky Goku, but when you saw him angry, like, he was, like, that was something you just didn't do. And that whole different martial arts aesthetic, and seeing, like, what type of different styles was Goku gonna learn and use to defeat so and so enemy. Like, I always found that amazing. And after I finish this video, there's probably gonna be more that I want to say. It's just how it is. It's 20 close to 30 odd years of just memories. You can't put that into a video. So yeah, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. Rest in peace, Akira Toriyama. Thank you for everything that you've done. And I wish I could do a better video, but I don't know how. I don't know how to justify it for you. But rest in peace. I'm not a religious person, but I hope that journey to Snake Way is a good one. You know, through Snake Way is a good one. And, yeah, I don't know. Take it easy. And catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine Devin Hansen. As always, people, peace.